Searching for a game coin was chump change compared to Mississippi Valley searching for his first win in 2 years. Valley wasted little time going after that win by taking it right to in-state rival Jackson State. After a scoreless first quarter, the Delta Devils' big break occurred when JSU's T.D. Davis mishandled a punt, giving Valley the ball at the Tigers' two-yard line. One play later, Garrick Jones found Trey Batista in the end zone for the score and the 6-0 lead.
We just got to step it up, man. I don't know what it was. Guys came out with a big head, you know. So we just got to get a little more humble and just start to come out harder.
The Devils did their best to be disruptive on this day. Valley limited JSU's high-powered offense to only 3 points in the first half. They went into the break with a 6-3 lead.
I mean, we don't expect any of our games to be close, but this one was, and as long as we can fight through and win it, I don't care if it's by half a point.
JSU's offense finally got in sync, and the Tigers put together a 5-play, 80-yard drive to open the third quarter, capped off by a 2-yard touchdown run by Tommy Gooden.
NASCAR, let's go NASCAR!
Valley would get back in the driver's seat and retake the lead when Marvin Pittman called his own number and raced 45 yards for the touchdown. However, the Tiger beating only lasted 30 seconds. Casey Terrio connected with Gooden on a 75-yard touchdown pass. It would prove to be enough as JSU holds off the Delta Devils 17-16.
But I think the defense played well enough, you know, to show that we weren't down or that we came out flat. You know, we came out together as a team, and that's where we play.
In Itabena, Mississippi, I'm Rob J. for Inside the Game.